Greetings everybody, Okami of Games Online. Welcome back to more Sunset Overdrive. Last time, we found out robots have emotions. Who knew? And in this episode, we're back here at the Oxford's base to talk to Forkim.
My name is Forkim.
Hey, sorry about that whole banished from the troop thing.
It's for the best. Troopmaster Norton is a bad guy. Even though he says he's trying to find Brill Cream, he's not. I overheard him whisper something about Troopmaster Brill Cream at the hot dog factory.
I hear this Brill Cream guy is really smart.
He's a genius.
A genius that might be trapped in a hot dog factory?
I'm worried. He's been missing for a couple of weeks.
We'll find him.
You mean I'll find him?
Someone has to stay here and comfort Forkim.
Right. Keep up the good work, Sam.
Okay, hot dog. Look for Troopmaster Brill Cream at the hot dog factory. I can read things. Alright. Let's go to the hot dog factory.
What's the deal with the hot dog factory? If you're trying to survive the apocalypse, hot dogs are the last thing you should eat.
Troopmaster Brill Cream is a master at boosting morale. Maybe he thought a hot dog cookout would lift the spirits of the troop.
Oh, that's funny, because I prefer to lift my spirits with actual spirits.
Alcohol is a depressant and has many health risks.
You're right. Better to eat processed pig lips and assholes. So that's healthy.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm at the hot dog factory.
Look around for signs of Troopmaster Brook.
Scabs. And it looks like they decided to upgrade their arsenal.
Oh, dandy.
Let me get those weapons. They're not smart enough to design them on their own.
Yeah.
You might have to deal with some scabs while you look for evidence.
You think?
Uh-huh.
Found a Japanese sword. Not something a troop leader would have.
Yeah, seems weird, doesn't it? But it could be Brill Cream's. He never went anywhere without it.
I feel like that could have been useful intel to have at the top of this caper.
But we need more evidence.
Alright, is there anything in here? Oh, there's something. His hat.
A troop leader's hat. Seems like something a troop leader would wear.
That could be Brill Cream's. He was always wearing his hat. I think we just need one more piece of evidence.
You guys sure do things by the book, don't you?
Troopmaster Brill Cream teaches us that discipline is the most important virtue.
Discipline. Yeah, I'm unfamiliar with that word. Found a bugle. Now that would only be something a troop leader would have, right?
Brooklyn carried a bugle, sometimes, but I'm not sure why he would have brought that with him.
Yeah, you're right. This could be anyone's bugle.
Okay, I'm convinced. Either Brooklyn is here, or he was here. You should check inside the factory.
Alright, well, I've been back here on a number of occasions, but have not been able to figure out how to get inside the damn factory. Maybe there's a way in there?
He's a trained survivalist. He may have locked himself inside. See if you can find a way to bust down a door, or even a wall.
A wall, you say? Nope, had to try. Okay, there's probably somewhere
where we can break in. Is there any construction equipment around? Anything that might help you get inside?
Construction equipment, hmm? What is around the area? Maybe this?
Use the crane to bust down the wall.
Okay.
This is our turf!
Can't be too difficult.
No keys. Wait, cranes have keys? Huh. What would Batman do? Probably read this note out loud. Meet me in the park for a picnic. I love you. Well, that's helpful. Guess I'm going to the park to look for some keys. And maybe even have a date.
Yeah, keep dreaming. Oh, God. Hey, I gotta remember I have that.
Sam's not being too annoying, is he?
Not anymore. He kept trying to hold my hand, so I put my judo badge into action and snared him in a rear naked choke.
Nice. But go easy on him. I get the sense he doesn't have much experience with the ladies.
Well, he's been a perfect gentleman since. He showed me around, I met his friends. He even taught me how to do a little C++ coding.
Wow, sure to invite me to the wedding. I love free food.
Wait, what?
Yeah. Well, I haven't done C++ coding. I've done a little bit of coding, but that's beside the point.
Okay, I found the picnic site. Looks like the crane guy either turned OD or was mauled. Damn, I need those keys to the crane.
If we're lucky, he turned OD. Go kill some and see if any of them have the key.
Ah, just what I need. Fizco bots.
Bam, bloody tastic. Well, let's get down to business. Our acid sprinkler is almost level 5, so I'll be using that for a little bit. Oh. Okay. Looks like we got a new move available to us now. Sweet. I like getting new moves. It's gonna help us also get to high places when need be. Okay, I want to attack some OD. My freaking acid sprinkler, that is. Like, right there. It is right there. Right at just about level 5. I only need, like, not many more kills. And then it will be level 5, and I will be an incredibly happy person. Because that will be one more weapon we have at level 5.
Junkers!
Junkers? What? Oh, God. No, not you, assholes. There we go, level 5. No longer need to use the acid sprinkler, which means what I am going to do... Oh, that was the right button. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take off that stun rounds level 2 so we can give it to something maybe a bit better. Let's give it to... I'm going to give it to this one. Stun rounds level 2, and the dude is going to get burn baby level 2. Anything else? I'm gonna give this one the Bear Force one. Okay. That should be good. Now let's get to business. Nice. Yeah, this is already looking pretty good. Roman Candle is pretty close to level 3, so let's see if we can get that upgraded enough. Yeah, I think he got burned.
Hey, keys.
Of course, yeah, I become like the super strong asshole. Oh well. We at least got the keys. At the cost of a little bit of health, but it was also worth it.
You there?
Because,
Yes. Did you find the key?
Yeah, but I have something more important to talk about.
Okay.
So what do you think of Sam? Really?
I don't know why, but he kind of reminds me of this class turtle we had in fourth grade. We set him free in the ocean one day, then we found out later he was a freshwater turtle.
Don't tell Sam that story.
Gotta love the humor, and I really like all their plays on all the different tropes. Like, how they mess with your expectations, like what you would normally expect. They kind of just take and do the opposite of, which is pretty awesome.
Ooh.
Almost there. Okay. Dash! Oh boy.
On the ice team!
I should really take advantage of this. When am I gonna get a chance to destroy stuff in a crane again?
Ooh.
Damn it, those pallets were actually overcharged deliveries. Now this place is about to be stupid with OD.
Good thing I have godlike crushing power.
I better crush those OD before they turn into poppers.
Yeah, probably smart idea. If I could get back on the ground... yep, I can't exit out of the crane. I'm stuck in crane mode. I was gonna get out and like put out some turret copters to get them some level... to get them some experience, but nope. Can't do that. And well, that works. Oh, boy. That's... nuts. Well, that... Oh, God. Popper. Popper! Uh-oh. Okay, now we're... Okay, what the balls? This is a little bit of bullshit. Okay, is that all of them? Son of a bitch is right. Get over here. Okay, that wasn't too bad. That was kind of awesome. Come on. Come on. I don't want to deal with any poppers. Nope. Hey.
I got violated about 1,000 oceans, but at least I'm having fun.
Yeah. At least we're having fun. That's the important thing. Friggin' Herker. Die. Never gonna get over these stupid. Nope. Pop. Hate those poppers as well. And that's getting the single thing that kills me is friggin' poppers. At least I will auto pick up health by the looks of things. Alright. That works. Be the last one? I think that's the last one.
Victory! Now let's smash open that wall and see if real cream is inside.
Alright. That was a little more hectic than I was hoping it would be. Let's grab our freaking overcharge and get inside. And we can also get that phone that's been taunting me for however long. Let's do that first. Yay! Alright, Brill Cream. Coming for ya. Oh, what's this?
Found a note from Brill Cream. Dated 2 weeks ago.
What does it say?
It says, hot dog spoiled, heading to Hepcats to meet Norton. Scab's on my trail, we'll try to lose them.
Let's meet at Hepcats and look for more clues. I knew Norton was involved somehow.
Well, we did it. Found Troop Mr. Brill Cream's journal. Sounds like Norton is involved somehow. Norton! Got new quests.
Hey, Norton.
How's new challenges.
Brill Cream going?
Not good. I believe it's time to call it off.
Not yet. I'm following up on a lead.
Oh?
I found a note from Brill Cream. He said he was going to meet you at Hepcat's Diner. Whatever happened with that?
Well, as I recall, he never showed up. Where did you find that note?
You're lying, Norton. What are you hiding?
How dare you? A troop master never lies. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have important troop matters to attend to.
Yeah, I think that BS meter was not just for show. But, what do we want to do then? Because, oh, did we get a new weapon?
Compensate for your lack of...
No, I don't... Murderang! Fires a boomerang-style projectile that slices through enemies, now affecting its trajectory, then returns towards the player while continuing to deal damage. You regain your ammo if you manage to catch the murdering projectile. Let's equip that in place of... let's equip that in place of nothing but the hits. Murderang. And we don't have an amp slot yet, but I'll definitely be trying to get that. Let's use it for a bit, see what it's like.
Meet me at Hepcat's Diner. I think Forkim could be in trouble.
On my way.
Okay. I can get behind this. And I can, if I catch the ammo, it comes back to me. That is pretty awesome, if you ask me. Alright. Let's look at our map. Because... yep, there is another sub-quest over here. So we'll do this sub-quest, and we'll see how much time we have left. And based on that, we'll see if we'll do the challenges or not. Or maybe more of my interest. Nah, we'll do this sub-quest.
Hey, Norton. How's that search for Brill Cream going?
Oh, we just heard this.
I believe it's time to call
we literally just heard this not long ago.
Up on a lead.
Oh?
I found a note from Brill Cream.
Okay, right here.
He said he was going to meet you at Hepcat's Diner.
I need to work on my maritime
badges. What happened with that?
Scabs on the
well,
whole waterfront.
Well, as I recall,
you run them out of there?
Showed up.
Permanently?
Where did you find that note?
You know about
You're
scabs.
You're lying, Norton. You get rid of them, and the next day they've all just
How
respawned.
How dare you? A troop master never lies. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have important troop matters to attend to.
Okay, I'm sorry if anybody cared about that dialogue, because it got ruined by Troop Master Norton. To cure a case of scabs, help a trooper scare away scabs from the pier.
First things first, I need to find a herker, but it needs to be a really ugly one.
Alright, let's go find the ugly herker. Sam? What? You're trying to call me for something, Sam. You want something? No? Okay, that's cool. This game is really being glitchy, isn't it? More overcharge that I can smash. Let's go this way. Almost there. I say that vaguely. Ooh, toilet paper. Toilet paper. I need me my toilet paper. Sweet. Got more toilet paper. More of the toilet papers. And oh, more toilet paper. We are finding a lot of toilet paper apparently. Okay, we're almost right. Yep, I see the herker off there in the distance.
Hey there, big guy. Sorry, but I gotta kill you and take your head. Don't worry, it'll be fun.
It'll be fun, we swear. Oh god. Okay, maybe not like that. Oh god. Good thing we have our electricity powers. Alright. Now the herker's gone. Get the head.
Now to the waterfront.
Turn over to the waterfront. Do 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 do. Sam's still trying to call me for something. Doesn't want to say a damn thing, apparently. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we glitched the game. It's not a major glitch, though, so I'm not worried.
Time to scare these scabs off. Permanently.
Alright, let's get moving. Let's equip... turret cop. Actually... Roman candle.
What the hell is that?
Yeah. I'm gonna eat you alive.
Wow, so scared. Oh, well, I guess it's working. As long as we keep killing scabs like this, maybe we'll scare them off for good. Well, of course we're not gonna scare them off for good. They'll be back. Oh, wow, the Roman candle's really close to level 3. That is pretty kick-ass. Fuck. Hey, Sam's not trying to call me anymore. Guess he got scared as well. Sam, you wuss. Dude, if you saw someone running around their undergarments in a herker mask and lit fire wherever they scared, you'd be scared too, dude. Don't even deny it. And that, to a degree, could fly. Yeah, this is fun. Oh, and we're in batshit crazy style. Even better. Which means I'm not gonna be able to put it to use. Some use.
Regroup further down the waterfront. We can take it if we stand together.
Well, there we go, level 3 Roman candle now. Nice! Yeah, I don't think your plan's working, Scabs. Just saying. I'm out of ammo for my thing. Alright, let's use Freeze Bomb next, since it does have some stuff. Wait, what do you mean, roll? Oh, thank you for letting me know my controller batteries are low. I'm going to replace them after the recording is over. I guess I can't complain, because it's been a while since I did have to replace my controller batteries.
You scared them all away. They're never coming back after that. Thank you so much.
Sure thing. It was fun. I guess it backfired a little.
Back off! I'm not one of you!
Yay! We did it! And now there's a shit ton of OD. Well, I guess that's also gonna work.
How's that search for Brill Cream go?
Now we can do this. We're back to our normal clothing.
I believe it's time to call it off.
Not yet. I'm following up on a lead.
Yeah, this is gonna be getting me a lot of experience for my weapons. Cool. So, I think the way we're gonna close off this episode is we're gonna head back to Two-Head Jack, see if he's got any new weapons, and show those off if he does. If he doesn't, then we're just gonna end it off. So, okay, this is pretty good. And I'll be able to, hopefully by the next episode, I'll have the murder ring to at least level 2, so we can equip an amp to it. But for now, let's head on back to the officer's base. So, that's gonna be a thing. We have new weapons, because there's gonna be a lot of crazy weapons coming up based on what we've already gotten. Do we have to get this message this often? God, good thing we're doing this soon. We're gonna be doing challenges next episode that'll start off.
He said he was going to meet you.
All right, Jack.
Cat's Diner. Never happened with that.
We've got what you need. We have proximity mines.
You're lying, Norton. What are you hiding?
Alright, what do we want to equip this to then? We'll show this off really quick, and then we're gonna go ahead and end off the episode. So we let's replace our acids. What? Okay, that's what murdering. So murdering is really good against the Fizco bots. Got it. Alright. Let's swap on over to our new weapon, the proximity mine. I'll just sticky mines that attach to objects and search for enemies that come in close proximity before exploding.
Have important troop matters to attend to.
Okay, so let's test this out really quick. Then we're gonna call it an episode. It's a Herker down the street, so let's test it out on you. Hey Herker, come here!
Meet me at Hepcat's Diner. I think Fortkin could be in trouble.
On my way.
Okay, yeah, pretty much what I expected. So now we've done that. Next time on Sunset Overdrive. We're gonna be heading over to do some challenges, then we're gonna get on with the next story mission. See you guys then.